start out with just a couple of holes. I don't usually drill any more than I need right away. So I'll drill one for a tip up, and then I'll drill one to jig in. I'll put the duck slide down there and see if there's any fish around. Lake trout, they adjust their depth seasonally. They're very temperature sensitive. They're cold water fish. And so they're going to follow the depths that put them in a comfortable range and also allow them to feed. So in the wintertime, their average depth that we find them at is usually around 30 feet, 40 feet of water. The other advantage of the flasher with even fishing tip-ups is I can use it to set my depth. I'm going to put the smelt on this one about a foot off the bottom. I usually put them anywhere from 1 to 6 feet off the bottom. Lake trout are bottom feeders. They're going to cruise the bottom and they're going to swim within, you know, the bottom couple of feet of water. We're in 37 feet right here, which is a great depth for lake trout. See on the Vexilar that the flip shot and the bait and the swivel will all show up. I like to chum, especially if I'm going to be staying in an area for a while. It brings in fish, it puts some scent and food on the bottom for them, and those down there. Well, the important thing with chum is more is not better. You don't want to put too much chum down there because they'll just come in and eat your chum and won't eat your jig. These fish will, they have seasonal migrations, lake trout, but for the most part, the fish that are in this large area here are going to stay in this area all day. They'll be here for the day, so it's one of the reasons that I often move around a lot is because you'll end up fishing for the same fish over and over again. I believe that a lake trout makes up his mind within the first few seconds after seeing your jig whether or not he's going to eat that jig. Got him. Laker on. This isn't a very big fish, but they're fun. I fish a lot of panfish, so every time I switch over and start fishing for lakers, it feels like I've got a giant on here. Oh, it's a giant white perch. That's one of the biggest white perch I've ever caught. I'm a giant New Hampshire white perch. White perch are almost always in the same area as the lake trout, which is, it's great. I'll always have some light action panfish rod with me for fish like that. But I mean, they obviously will hit the bucktails too. And yeah, I do most of my Lake Winnipesaukee guided trips or combo trips that we're looking for lake trout and white perch at the same time. We got a flag off over here. Let's pull a little bit of line off there so that as I set it down, the fish doesn't feel me. When I feel that weight, set the hook. Try to lay that line on the ice loosely and not step on it. I think this is a white perch. There's the swivel. This is the white perch. I fish a lot of days in this shelter that I couldn't fish outside of it. The heater going, a day like today, I don't know if I could stay outside all day long without having a place to at least get in and get warmed up every now and again. When they come in at it like that, but they won't eat it, a lot of times if you just leave it on the bottom and just wiggle it a little bit but don't lift it off the bottom, they'll come over and pick it up off the bottom.
Got him.
Fish on. Yep, nice laker. It's a nice one. Another nice New Hampshire lake trout. Caught on one of AJ's bucktails. He's probably 18 inches. And get him back in the water. See if we can't get another one. There he goes. So the power of this Vexilar is that we've been fishing for these Lakers most of the day and watching how they react to the jig. And based on how they're reacting, I was able to figure out that they really want it set on bottom. They spook easy when they chase it. Without the Vex, it would have taken me a day or days to figure something like that out. Got him. Oh, two of them come in that time. Much better fish. Another nice New Hampshire lake trout.